here to be a part of history of the Old Lord's Church. Noah Webster House is our meeting place for our Colonial History Club. And Noah Webster is a writer, he was a photographer, writer of the first American dictionary. In fact, he actually wrote three dictionaries in his lifetime, among other various writings on pestilential diseases, the weather. He also wrote many of the articles and ideas for our Constitution. He was not given credit, however, for that. I think he thought very highly of himself. He was extremely smart. His wife had 8 children, so you can imagine how busy she was at home when he was off learning 26 languages and learning the American dictionary. Before we begin, I'd like to tell you that everyone here, we brought a little treat for you from a chocolatier at the Noah Webster House named Mary Ann Sharon, a little shy. And she's made little chocolate houses for you, so on the way out, if you could please take one as a little treat and a memento for our program. Before I begin, I'd like to thank Erin Miskitis. She's the education director here at the Old North Church. I'd like to thank the board of directors and also Tim, he's the caretaker here at the North Church, for helping us with setup. Thank Mrs. Pena and the children for coming for practice faithfully. And also the Swanson family, Monica and Veronica, for bringing their children to practices and also for filming us. And I'd like to also especially thank my husband, he's back there, and my daughter Tempe, and Steve Bloomberg, who's my husband, and I'm the leader of the Notes of Americans. And we dedicate this to Carmelo Pena, who is a true American patriot. He's overseas right now, fighting for our country. Before I begin, I'd like to tell you our name of our shadow play. Shadow plays have been here for about 2,000 years. They were not popular until the Revolutionary War time period in the colonies here. And then they became very popular. All you need is a white source, a screen, and some silhouettes and some fun. So to do that, and they would have done that by candlelight in the 1700s. However, since we're the Noah's new Americans, we're using an overhead projector. So if our play is entitled Paul Revere's Ride, and it's by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, written in 1860. Good evening, sir. How are you?
Good.
Let me introduce our members to you. This is Mistress Anna Marie Lane. She's a most ardent patriot. Thank you. about this at tea tomorrow. You are all invited. We should talk about it later.
And Mrs. Luddington, I noticed how you accompanied your daughter on this ride tonight, but not on my last ride.
Yes, well, my daughter is a very capable rider indeed. But now I do fear for her safety. Her notoriety will spread all the way across.
Silently rode to the Charlestown shore. Just as the moon rose over the bay, where swinging wide at her moorings lay, the Somerset, British man of war, a phantom ship with each mast and spar, across the moon like a prison bar, and the huge black hulk that was magnified by its own reflection in the tide. Meanwhile, his friend, rallying street, wanders and watches his eager ears, till in the silence around him he hears the mustered men at their door! The sound of arms and the tramp of feet! And the measured tread of the red ears marching down to their boats on the shore. Then he climbed the tower of the old North Church by the wooden stairs with stealthy tread to the belfry chamber overhead and startled the pigeons from their perch on the somber rafters that round him made massive and moving shapes of shade. By the trembling ladder, steep and tall, to the highest window in the wall, where he paused to listen and look down at the woman on the roofs of the town and the moonlight flowing over all.
Watchful night wind as it went, creeping along.
to mount and ride. Booted in spur with a heavy stride, on the opposite shore walked Paul Revere. Now he patted his horse's side. Now he gazed the landscape far and near. Then, impetuous, stamped the earth, and turned and tightened his saddle girth. But mostly he watched with eager search the belfry tower of the old North Church, as it rose above the graves on the hill, lonely and spectral and somber and still. And lo, as he looks on the belfry's height, a glimmer and then a gleam of light. He springs to the saddle, the bridle returns, but lingers and gazes till full on his sight, a second lamp in the belfry burns.
Riding with us tonight.